Hi everyone, my name is Dr. Amy Hogan and today I'm going to be talking to you about perception, the ability to become aware of something through our senses. I'm going to be talking to you about the differences between sensation and perception. But first, let's have a look at this picture. As we look at this picture, our eyes are taking in the image of seeing some horseback riders going through the woods. But when I tell you that the image is called "The Forest Has Eyes," you perhaps start to perceive something different. You start to see faces everywhere. How many faces can you see? I'll give you a few moments to have a look through the image. Okay, let's go through and count them. There are 13 in total. How many did you get? There's one here, it's like a partial face. Two. Three, a little profile. Four, five, and six. Seven. How many of you got this one in the white tree? Number eight. Coming down to the bottom, nine, we have a sideways face here. 10, 11, 12, mouth, nose and eyes, and 13. So sensation is the process by which our sensory receptors and our nervous system receive and represent stimulus energy. So of course our five main senses are vision, hearing, smell, taste and touch. Perception, on the other hand, is the process of organising and interpreting that sensory information, which enable us to recognise meaningful objects and events. Let's have a look at this. Here's a little dragon, and watch what happens when we move side to side. His eyes appear to follow us. It's all an illusion, of course. It's a version of the hollow face illusion. Our brain has made an assumption about the structure of his face. Based on our prior knowledge of faces, we interpret the concave face as being convex. And when we move around to the side, we see that the illusion fails. The dragon illusion is a very powerful way of showing how our incoming sensory information is shaped and selected and influenced by our prior learning. The brain has a really strong knack for seeing faces everywhere. For example, let's look at this bit of toast. What do you see? Some people say that they see the Virgin Mary. Personally, I see Michael Jackson. Maybe it's just a bit of toast. So our brains are doing more than just registering sensory information. We are constantly organising, filtering and interpreting information in ways that make sense to us. So to recap, sensation is a passive, often unconscious process of bringing information from the outside world into our body and the brain. On the other hand, perception is the active process of selecting, organising and interpreting the information brought to the brain by the senses. So let me leave you with these two questions. Can we sense without perceiving? And more importantly, can we perceive without sensing?